हेलो चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ विशाल पांडे एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब क्लास. सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ ब्रिटिशर्स केम टू इंडिया एंड हाउ पुर्तगीज केम टू इंडिया, हाउ फ्रेंच केम टू इंडिया एंड दे केम इन इंडिया फॉर द सेक ऑफ स्पाइसेस, फॉर द सेक ऑफ ट्रेडिशन, फॉर द सेक ऑफ ट्रेड. वी विल अंडरस्टैंड दिस इन द दिस वीडियो एंड इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियोज विल कम ऑल्सो. वी विल अंडरस्टैंड द ब्रिटिशर्स मोर डीपली. So without wasting any time, let us begin the lecture. From trading post to presidency, the early visits of company ships to the east were for exploration. The captains of the ships sought out suitable places and asked for permission to trade from local rulers. So when the company's ship used supposed to came India, the captains used to take permissions from the local rulers, the kings, those who were ruling at that particular area. The captains used to take permission, because without permission no captain is allowed to do trade and move here and there in the kingdom of any king. If trade proved profitable, the captain set up trading post called factories, named after the officials of the company who were called factors. So when the trade supposed to be profitable, when trade supposed to be profitable for the captains, they used to stay there and they used to do trade throughout the year. So in the more successful areas, groups of factories developed which were known as settlements. Some of these settlements developed into centers to which other factories in the region reported and came to be called presidencies. Now let us understand what is settlement and what is presidency. When people used to come, when Britishers used to come in India, and they used to take permission of local rulers, if the trade becomes successful, then they used to settle there. That was called settlement. And if some settlements developed into centers, when settlement means what? In short term we are saying settlement. When it will grow, it will develop, ultimately it will become presidency. So in the larger context we can call it presidency. The presidencies were administered by a governor and a council of senior factors. Altogether, presidency was looked by governors. So the British made official contact with India for the first time in 1606. Captain William Hawkins landed in Surat in 1607 and went to Agra to secure trading privileges. So first man to visit India when Jahangir was king, son of Akbar. So he was supposed to sit in Agra because Agra was his capital. So altogether Jahangir met William Hawkins. Captain Hawkins came and he visited to Agra. In 1612, a firman was obtained from Mughal Emperor Jahangir giving permission to set up factories at Surat. So altogether Jahangir gave permission to William Hawkins to set factories in Surat, which is there in Gujarat. Surat was nominated as the company's center of trade in the east, because Gujarat is there in the it is there on the western ghat of India. But when we compare Europe from India, India always supposed to be there in eastern side. So that is why it is called trade in the east. From Europe, India is on the eastern side. That is why European named the company East India Company, because India is situated at the east side and east. So that is why it is called East India Company. The British made official contact with India for the first time in 1606. Captain William Hawkins landed in Surat. Altogether, what I told you earlier. So this was the fact, this was the reality, how Captain William Hawkins came to India. One more explorer came here and his name was Sir Thomas Rowe, and he was sent by King James I of England. So King James I of England sent Sir Thomas Rowe in the before Jahangir to take permission. Ambassador to the court of Jahangir, Sir Thomas Rowe received permission in 1616 to set up factories in any part of the Mughal Empire. So what is the difference between the permission of Captain Hawkins and Sir Thomas Rowe? Captain Hawkins got the permission to set up the factories only in Surat, which is there in Gujarat, but Thomas Rowe got the permission from Jahangir to set the factories any part of the India. He can set the factories in any part of the India. So this was the difference between the permission of these two. British trade with India increased and so did their power. The city of Calcutta grew from three villages where the company was given rights to collect tax. Bombay soon became a British stronghold and replaced Surat as the centers of the company's activities on India's western coast. So altogether, Surat was leading for the first time, but when Bombay came in existence, Bombay started leading in terms of western Ghat coast. Now let us understand how British's conquest of India, you know, British dominated in India, how British captured India. We will understand in this paragraph, and this, you know, we will continue to understand throughout the chapter. Starting out as traders operating from small trading outposts, the Europeans soon established powerful colonies in the east. Altogether, they started their journey from traders, and altogether they are now up to colonize the eastern eastern areas, the leading country which is known as India. So what is colonizing? Development of a colony. जब हम किसी दूसरे जगह पे जाके अपने पावर को establish करते हैं और कोई colony बनाते हैं तो उसको हम कहते हैं colonization. You have to keep this in your mind. And the process of colonization is called colonialism. Okay? So this is colonialism. The European powers fought bitter battles among themselves for control over the lucrative trade with the East, especially India. Altogether, all the European country, France, we can understand France, Portuguese, Dutches, and England. France, Portuguese, Dutches, England. ये चारों जो है आपस में लड़ते थे. क्यों? क्योंकि इनमें से सब चाहते थे कि इंडिया में कोई एक ही राज करे. सो ऑल टुगेदर दे यूज टू फाइट. द पोर्तुगीज हावेवर वर अनेबल टू रिटेन मोस्ट ऑफ द पोजेशंस इन इंडिया आफ्टर स्पेन कंकर्ड पुर्तगाल इन 1580. सबसे पहले पुर्तगीज ही आए इंडिया में और उनका गोवा पे मोनोपोली था, बट स्पेन के जो कंकर्ड थे, जो स्पेन के जो यू नो रूलर्स थे, एक्सप्लोरर्स थे, वो आए और अल्टीमेटली Dutch decided to focus their attention on their possessions in the East Indies. So all together they were, you know, competing. Ek competition ka atmosphere tha in sab mein to grow, to develop by, you know, power or by currency, or they want to, you know, have a control, full control over this country which is known as India. If we talk about Carnatic Wars, there were three wars. Such wars were very famous wars, which was fought against France and England. We will understand, because these two countries were leading country in India, which they used to extend their monopoly. Dutch or Portuguese were, you know, very not as much as strong like France and England. तो France और England में लड़ाइयाँ हुई तीन बार. कहाँ कहाँ हुई? We will understand. In India, the conflict between the French and the British was focused around the Carnatic region, the southern eastern part of the Indian Peninsula. देखिए, Carnatic wars means Karnatak, जो आज हम कह रहे हैं Karnataka. So वहाँ के area में ये लड़ाई हुई. We will understand कहाँ पे. The three states of this region, Hyderabad, Carnatic and Mysore, were in constant conflict with each other. इन तीनों में आपस में कभी नहीं पड़ती थी. So they were both among these three states. People used to, and the rulers used to, especially rulers used to fight against each other. The British had a fortified settlement in Madras and the French had one in Pondicherry. So this was the reflection of Britishers and French. Britishers were having a settlement in Madras and French were having a settlement in Pondicherry. So let us see what happens then. फ्रेंच एंड ब्रिटिश टुक एडवांटेज ऑफ द राइवलरी बिटवीन द इंडियन रूलर्स. इंडियन रूलर्स, आई होप यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड दैट हैदराबाद, कर्नाटक एंड मैसूर, ये तीन रीजन ऐसे थे जिसके किंग हमेशा आपस में लड़ते थे. इसका एडवांटेज किसने लिया? ब्रिटिशर्स ने लिया, यूरोपियंस ने लिया. लेट अस सी हाउ. दे अलाइड देमसेल्व विथ राइवल ग्रुप्स एंड फॉट थ्री वॉर्स बिटवीन 1746 एंड 1763 विच केम टू बी कॉल्ड द कर्नाटिक वॉर्स. द ब्रिटिश डिफीटेड द फ्रेंच कॉम्प्रिहेंसिवली. बाय द एंड ऑफ द थर्ड कर्नाटिक वॉर द फ्रेंच रिटेन्ड ओनली पॉन्डिचेरी एंड चंदेनगर एंड दे वर नॉट अलाउड टू फोर्टिफाई इवन दीज. द ब्रिटिश वर नाउ द मेन यूरोपियन पावर इन इंडिया. सो दिस इज वॉट यू हैव टू कीप इन दिस योर माइंड दैट दिस फैक्ट इज कनेक्टिंग यू विथ योर हिस्ट्री एंड हाउ ब्रिटिशर्स डिफीटेड फ्रांस इन सदर्न इंडिया. सो दिस वॉज द रिफॉर्मेशन ऑफ ब्रिटिश पावर. दिस इज द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ ब्रिटिश पावर इन इंडिया. नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंक्वेस्ट ऑफ बंगाल. इट विल बी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक. सो जस्ट वॉच दिस वीडियो एंड अंडरस्टैंड ईच एंड एवरी थिंग. मेक श्योर दैट ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो आई विल गिव यू सम क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन इट. यू हैव टू सर्च द आंसर्स एंड राइट इन योर नोटबुक. सो आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरी वन टू मेक नोटबुक, स्पेसिफिक नोटबुक फॉर SST. Okay, so we'll meet you in the next video.